We got a comment on a video recently, and it was pretty insightful and got us thinking. They asked, if I lower my speed, does it automatically lower my feed? And the short answer is no. No, it doesn't do it automatically. But we've got a setting on the control, and if it's turned on, it'll link our speed and feed overrides if that's what we want. By speed, we're talking about our RPM value, our revolutions per minute. And by feed, we're talking about our F value, our feed rate per minute, in either inches or millimeters. By default, as mills leave the factory, if we override our spindle speed, lowering it 10%, that's not going to affect our feed rate at all. It's going to remain unchanged at 100%. Now, this does change the math, and we've made videos on this. It'll increase our chip load, our feed per tooth. Now, this extra load on our tool can dampen it, reducing chatter. That's a neat little trick for just pushing one little button. But if reducing chatter isn't the issue, if we just want to reduce cycle times, we might want to try turning on and setting 144, feed override spindle. Now, when that setting is on, it links our speed and feed overrides. Now, if we bump up our feed rate override, it's going to automatically increase our spindle override to match, giving us a constant feed per tooth without risking extremely high chip loads. So we can, one, leave setting 144 off to control our speed and feed overrides independently, maybe to increase our chip load and reduce chatter, or two, we can turn it on, which will link our speed and feed overrides if that's what we want. So we've got options. Thank you.